Hi everyone, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we have another unboxing for you, a small one. We got a load of games in from Buttonshy and we wanted to highlight a few of them so you can check them out over on the online store and the TikTok shop as well. But let's get into showing you what you can find inside Fishing Lessons. So all the Buttonshy games fit in your wallet. They are designed to fit in your pocket, your wallet, to be very transportable there. So we got Fishing Lessons here, which is a solo game completely designed by Scott Arms. It's been a year since Leland Williams passed on. As members of his family going out on a solo fishing trip, apply Leland's lessons to have a great day on the lake. You'll play as a family member with their own unique goal. During each round, you'll recall one of Leland's lessons, adding it to your list of steps that you'll then run through in order trying to complete your goal. So these are very cute little games that you can find over on the TikTok shop in the online store, and I'll show you what's inside, and maybe a little bit how it works too. He says, got a little bit of card there, but just the wallet. So inside you've got cards. So we got Fishing Lessons. So we got the little rule book here, which tells us all about the things. There are 3 family cards, which are double-sided, 7 lake cards, and 8 lesson cards. So we've got here our 3 family cards, our double-sided family cards. We've got these appear to be lesson cards. Yep, they're lesson cards. We've got our lake cards here as well, with different letters and fish on them. So what we'll do, well, we might as well just set it up as if we were playing, right? So we shuffle the 7 lake cards. So we got these, give them a quick shuffle. And this is only for 1 player as well, which is quite cool. Shuffle these and deal them face down in a row to represent the lake. It all flows very nicely too. This one over here, why not? Cool, so we got our lake. Choose any family card and put it either side up above the center lake card to indicate your position. So I am Maya, the wife. Shuffle the lesson cards to form a deck and place it face down below the lake, leaving space around it for a lesson row and discard pile. All right, we'll chuck that there like that. Draw 3 lesson cards to form your hand. 1, 2, 3. So we've got 3 lesson cards here with some flavor text down at the bottom, I assume from Leland. Choose a difficulty level. So in step 3, check your goal. Let's go easy. I don't know what the difficulties are right now, but we'll see when we get to there. So use Leland's lessons to meet your fishing goal before time runs out. Each turn proceeds through the following steps in order. Begin each turn by choosing a lesson card from your hand and either insert it into the lesson row or replace an existing card there. So insert the new card at any spot in the lesson row at either end or in between other cards in the row. You can shift other lesson cards as needed to make room, but do not reorder them. Okay. Replace any existing card in the lesson row. Discard the card you're replacing and place the new card in the old card's location. So that's step 1. So let's do, I don't know. Let's do this. So then we go to step 2, which is activate the lesson. So we activate each card in the lesson row, 1 at a time from left to right. Resolve each card's effects from top to bottom. If part of an effect can't be resolved, ignore it and resolve the others if possible. With playing easy difficulty, check your goal after activating each card. So this has a move effect and a flip effect. So let's look at the flip effect first. You flip lake cards based on their position relative to you. Positions outside of the lake are not flipped. For example, if an effect flips 2 lake cards, but 1 is past the edge of the lake, flip only the other card. So in this case, I'm going to flip in this direction here. So we go boop and boop. So we've got some catfish, we've got a bluegill, we've got a silver carp. Now there is also the move effect on this card, and so we also resolve that effect as well. You move left or right above the lake with each lake card representing 1 space. So I can move 1 or 3. So let's just move to there. I don't know what's happening. If you would move beyond the edge of the lake, you stop at the edge instead. If you're already at the edge, you may skip movement by attempting to move beyond that edge and stopping. So then we flip this up. So now I would check my goal. It takes both luck and skill to find the right fish. Let's see if you've met your fishing goal today. Each character has a unique fishing goal. So Maya's goal here is to get 3 C's and 2 B's on face-up cards. In this case, I have 2 C's, 1 B, so I would need an additional B and another C as well. So based on the game's difficulty, you'll see if you've met your goal at different times. So on easy, which I'm playing right now, I'd do that at the end of the lesson. In medium, it will be at the end of the turn. And at hard, it will be the end of the game. If I meet the goal, I win the game. So step four here is draw a new lesson. So I've got my lesson card, my hand here. If the deck is empty, the game immediately ends. Otherwise, draw a lesson card, then begin another turn. So let's go again. I know what I need to do. So let's do, because I don't want to flip these the other way around now. I want them there. So perhaps something like that could be handy. Doing that could also be good, actually. That's worth doing. So we're going to play. Oh, I have to resolve them in that order as well, which is quite annoying. I guess I can replace it, can't I? But that means that one would go to the discard pile. So I guess it's thinking about what lessons I want to put in front of me. But I think for right now, I'm playing on easy. I'm going to try and do what I think is the simple thing. So we're going to place a lesson by replacing this card in the lesson row. So that goes to the discard. I put that one down. And then we activate lessons. So we do this first, which is going to flip these two cards because this one is unaffected. So flip these two. So we've got another B and another C, which is what I wanted. So after placing lessons, activating lessons on easy mode, technically, I check I have met my goal. So technically, I have won, which is amazing. Absolutely fantastic. Easy. Easy, as the name says. But if I were to play medium, I would do that. Then I'd have to move. So we go 1, 2. If I wanted to go that way, then I would draw a new lesson. Then I would draw a new lesson. Then I would check my goal after activating and resolving all lessons. So then we, we've done it. We've completed it. And that is the game. So all you do is try and get those lessons out. And I guess on a harder difficulty, I would need to essentially stay at this level, really, with these cards face up and try and finagle my way to get into the bottom of the deck without getting any of these flipped back the other way around into the lake. And that is fishing lessons. And there's a few different other ways to play as well. And on top of easy, medium and hard, you've also got additional challenges like night fishing, which means you can replace a maximum of 2 lesson cards throughout the game. And boat ramp, which is during setup, you put your family card above the leftmost lake card instead of in the middle. To win, you must complete your fishing goal and you must be at the leftmost position when you do so. So that adds a bit of variance as well. This, where these cards are, is also variance. When the lessons come out is variance. And which family member you are also adds variance too, because it changes your goal. For example, the daughter wants all cards face up. And Carter, the brother, wants 2 B's, 2 C's, and 2 T's as well. So there's a lot of different variants in this. And for a quick, fun solo game that maybe you could play on the train or when you're bored or anything like that, it is a pretty fun one. So do check out Fishing Lessons over on the TikTok shop and the online store. Thanks for watching this video. I've been Johnny for Chaos Cards, and I will see you next time.